Ustream or YouTube because Ustream will not tolerate my ass. My neighbor Joe gave me some pot. And I need to put it to good use. Where the fuck is that lighter I just found?
Smoke. What did I do with the shit he gave me? It's in the kitchen, isn't it?
It's not that big of a deal. You're worried about it because you lost it. Here it is. Hello? Hi, Richard. What? Buddy, I know you'd never do anything against me. You're like my number one fan. Why would you do anything to hurt me? Exactly, buddy. Oh no, god damn it, Captain Obvious is in here. My neighbor brought me some weed. Yeah, I just need to find a filter. I need to find a filter for it so it doesn't all go down the tube. See, what will make a good filter? A stem. Perfect. Right here. Perfect. Stem. Marijuana stem makes a great filter. Sure, it's going to taste a little bad, but it's worth it. I'm gonna just start off with a little bit of it. It's real hard to get weed in Australia, isn't it? Well then why aren't you smoking with me, you fucking cunt? Cheerio then, what?
What makes you think I'm not?
Richard! I am your father! Join the dark side, Richard! The dark force is more powerful than you can imagine. Join the dark force, Richard.
I'm
Luke, I am your father.
Oh, thank you, Daddy. I've been high for you. Really don't know what to say. It's too strong to dry, too cold, please, waiter. Thank you.
Kelly! Hola, señorita.
Hello.
I love you.
I love you too.
I'm in love with Kelly Rose's personality. It's magnificent, almost. She is. She is a kind and caring person.
She's always so lovely on your screen. She's always so nice.
You don't get very many of those kind and caring people. Most people are fucking trolls, man. My head hurts. I'm eating orange. I didn't know you could eat a color. Please, Kelly Rose, tell me how you eat a fucking color. I'm not eating a color, Rose. I'm eating a fucking orange. I think my mom says this is very funny. Guy accidentally uses the handicapped bathroom. Story goes, guy, all the other stalls were full, and he's like, alright, fuck it, I'm handicapped. So he goes into the handicapped stall, and then he sees a pair of wheels roll up in front of him, and he's like, oh, fuck. So when he comes out of the stall, he does this. I'm sorry, it's all yours. If you're ever in serious trouble, that is an excellent way out. Just pretend you're retarded. I didn't mean to, I'm sorry. You know, everybody knows about David Bowie's death and shit, but nobody knew that Joe Cocker died like a week after, you fucking shameful cunts. Joe Cocker may not have made... He was up there with David Bowie on quality of songs. David Bowie did a few good ones. Joe Cocker had one real good one. And the lyrics to it, every time you listen to a Joe Cocker song, what song is it? It is, the Wonder Years song. You remember the, have you ever seen the Wonder Years, Richard? I know Kelly Rose has. Have you ever seen The Wonder Years, Richard?
Yes.
You like it? Of course you do. What white person doesn't like The Wonder Years?
I got the soundtrack.
That's Joe Cocker. The theme song to that fucking show is Joe Cocker. Joe Cocker, J-O-E space C-O-C-K-E-R. Joe Cocker. I've won the spelling bee! That CU fucker spelled David Bowie. D A V I D Bowie B O W I Y I V E I E David Bowie. You know, David Bowie was an incredible person because he came out and is like, hey, I'm gay, but everyone still loved his music. Well, most people did anyway. And Bowie wasn't faking either. He's like, yes, I'm actually gay. He was, I wish there were more movies, like, behind the scenes stuff with him and shit.
What about that song with Mick Jagger? Let's walk, don't look back. You know that one?
I know that David Bowie was once found in bed with Mick Jagger.
Don't look back.
What do you think David Bowie and Mick Jagger were doing in bed? It was Mick Jagger's wife that found him. Fucking divorced his ass because of it. Yeah, Mick Jagger's wife walked into the hotel room one night and caught Mick Jagger in bed with David Bowie, and she's like, ah, fuck. The fuck are you doing? You buy it! That's why Mick Jagger's wife divorced him. It's all in the book. The book she wrote. Rock stars' wives always write books about their fucking husbands. They do. They do. Look at the first one. Eric Clapton's wife. I've got something for yous. I'm eating I don't know what chibachu is. That like chewing tobacco? Fuck. This bitch has gum disease. I'm kidding. I didn't mean to call you a bitch. You're not a bitch. You are a very kind and loving person. There are, you see these people, these commenters, these viewers, some of them have been so disturbed in their life, they don't know anything more than trolling to try to make the other person feel bad.
It's
Why? I mean,
I don't know. cute, Nigel.
Me and you can't really understand why, because... I can understand it because I used to be a very, very negative person.
I am a negative person, but I'm a troll.
It's about taking that negativity, juggling it, and then turning it into comedy. Make fun of it. Why not? If you can, do it. Excuse me for a moment. I'm going to go fetch some ice. Good thing I went into the fucking kitchen. I was burning fucking soup. I like chicken broth and Gatorade. What do you think of the camel toe bit, Richard?
Brilliant, especially
I thought I might have overdone it last night. Like, I hiked up my pants to look like a camel toe, didn't I? Yes, I did. It doesn't. You just think it sounds terrible? Yes, it's weird. I will say that much. It's not terrible. It's a little weird, but it's not bad.
I can hear you clearly.
Clearly?
I can hear you
clearly. Sound repeats itself. Pass the bucket. We can understand each other quite well. Because we speak English. We're speaking the same language. If I'm speaking German or some shit, you have no idea what I'm saying. Hey, with the leather pants, you should wear the Morrison belt. The Morrison belt is broken. Or, I don't think it's broken, it's just really hard to get in the belt loops. I have Morrison. See that black thing with the white stick? That's Morrison. Yeah, you didn't know I had Morrison, did ya? He's right there on it. That's not a poster either. That's a fucking banner. Beautiful, isn't he? He's got the microphone right there and he's looking away like, hey, maybe I shouldn't sing. Fuck these people. I got one more hit. I think me and my neighbor are gonna go down to the marijuana office or dispensary tomorrow. Jesus Christ, nobody goes through smokes like I do. I am guaranteed to have fucking lung cancer. If I'm lucky, it won't turn into throat cancer. Now, what happens if I get throat cancer, don't you? It means I get a hole in my neck and I talk like this. Got a bag of cigarette, please. I like a bag of weekend. Red short. Another bag of wind then, Blaze. Red yard. But then again, old Willie Nelson beat throat cancer. He had throat cancer and somehow beat it. It's because he's got money, huh? The Chinese must have injected his throat with a bunch of weird drugs that fixed him. Yes, the Chinese have a cure to throat cancer. They just don't want to share it with us Americans. And why the fuck should they? We're almost their fucking enemy. They are like the last communism country on earth. And we will not fuck with them. Well, we do every now and again. Wrongly. We shouldn't fuck with China. But we do. Back in 2012, we bombed an American embassy inside of China. Why? Because we got false information. An American embassy was being overrun, so we bombed the fuck out of it. But when two Navy SEALs are begging for air support after saving several, like 70 lives, they don't get air support because Hillary Clinton is a fucking cunt! It came down to Hillary's decision on air support. Whether they're gonna fucking bomb them so our Navy SEALs can get the fuck out of there, or just not send anybody and fuck them. Hillary said fuck them. Who the fuck would vote for Hillary? I mean, really, you must be a fucking moron. That's what it's gonna come down to, is Hillary and Trump, and believe me, if you might as well be re-electing fucking Obama if you're gonna get Hillary in. No! They cannot be allowed. There needs to be like some NSA, CIA, anti-bullshit campaign that's going to kill Hillary Clinton if she gets in office. Our own people should fucking take her out if she gets in office. I'm sorry, I'm getting carried away with politics. I just hate that cunt so fucking much! Yes.
Oprah Winfrey wants to visit you.
Oh, bro, really, he can visit this.
Oh, God.
Oh, now you love us.
Glad you got a kick out of it.
Am I gonna come?
That's fun. That nearly makes me want to quit drinking. Oof. Oofta, oofta, oofta. Ton of bricks hitting you. You should whiskey scotch. I still got a fucking pinch of scotch left. I'm gonna pour it into the vodka.
Not the scotch, Mom, not the Harris.
Now it's scotch vodka. It's Scotty's vodka now.
I'm a scotch vodka.
This song's for Scotty! Cause Scotty doesn't know! Scotty doesn't know! Scotty doesn't know! Scotty doesn't know! Scotchka! I've just created a new type of fucking liquor! It's called Scotchka! Scotty doesn't know! Scotty doesn't know!
That's good.
Are you ready for Scotty doesn't know?
Hey, listen up, everybody. Got a little special thing I'd like to do tonight. We'll play a little song for you about the nastiest, freakiest little sex puppet I know, Fiona. This one's for you, baby.
Happy anniversary.
She's in church, but she doesn't go. Still, she's on her knees, and Scotty doesn't know. Scotty doesn't know. Scotty doesn't know. So tell Scotty. Scotty doesn't know. Scotty doesn't know.
The song is actually incredibly depressing. The poor kid's just sitting there watching this guy make fun of him. Ah, and a fucking loudspeaker with a fucking band playing. Yeah.
Still trust.
It's pretty depressing. As lively as it is, it's
You got
people that work the instruments for her are amazing because they don't just work the instruments. She's written the songs, especially the ones that are famous, like Maps. I think Maps comes from, it comes from Korea. Even though it's from Korea, it is a fucking brilliant song. Absolutely. I find it irresistible. But let's play something a little different.
Well,
Natural Born Killers. Something I Can Never Have. That's a Nine Inch Nails song. Oh, and it's pretty good. It's pretty good. It's pretty depressing, but it's pretty fucking good. You are about to hear it in 3, 2, 1.
I hear me.
Nails fan? Have you seen the video of the guy getting... Was that my cell phone? That was my cell phone. I don't know where my cell phone is! Anyway, stay to the subject. Have you seen the video when the guy gets tortured and basically they put his balls into a fucking coffee grinder? I used to think that was the worst. And it's not. There is far worse out there. There is always worse. Try to remember that. Life will always and always will can be better.
Just one. hand over your heart and try to feel your heartbeat. That the heart is the strongest muscle in the human but is it the tongue?
Though it all looks different now, I know it's still the same. Everywhere I look, you're all I see. Just a fucking reminder of who I used to be. Come on, tell me you'll make this all go away. You'll make this all go away. I'm back to just one thing, and I'm starting to scare myself. You'll make this all go away.
Kelly, how familiar are you with Karen O? Karen O. Karen with a K. Karen O. Did you know that she is the fucking singer for the Ya Ya Ya's? I'm going to play something a little deep. It's a children's song. Or it's from a lullaby, if you will. The song is called Kids, I think. No, is it? Fuck it, let's just do it and be happy. I haven't played this in a while, so you guys should be grateful to be able to. No, it's called Wild Things. All is no, it's called Karen O. Karen O and the Kids. All is Love. Oh. Yeah, it's pretty bad towards the end, but the beginning is not bad.
Where you Anybody here know how to work a video camera?
I used to be a studio executive.
I know video.
Really? You know how to work this kind of camera?
I owned one like it. You trying to sell it?
No, no. I need you to record. Yeah. Ready to roll, boss. Tommy, by the time you see this, I'll be dead.
Cut!
What?
How do I turn it off?
It's the fucking record button.
Check. And action.
Tommy, I'll make this as simple as I can. I love you. That's my rock bottom. That's my immutable. My damned and naked soul. I loved you from the moment you were born, all red and covered in mucusy stuff, until this moment right now. They say that love is pure and generous. It's not small and selfish. You know, I wanted you at the office because I couldn't envision anything finer than having you next to me. Altman, Altman, and Altman. What a dream. What you wanted, what you dreamed, I didn't want to hear it. I was wrong. I hope you can forgive me. I pray for your happiness. Whatever's swarming around you want to do, you have my love and my blessing. I'm sorry this only came clear to me now that I'm dying, but it's how life rolls out. The only people who don't look back with regret are idiots and psychopaths. And I got a lifetime of regrets, boy. Taken to a clerkship in Queens? What a fool not telling my father to... Why, I mean, what kind of god? What kind of world? It's a stinking con game. You grow up being told, wait for the sweets and the roses. Then they hit you with a pickaxe in the ear. Grief. Couldn't envision anything finer than having you next to me. Altman, Altman, and Altman. What a dream. What you wanted, what you dreamed, I didn't want to hear it. I was wrong. I hope you can forgive me. I pray for your happiness. Whatever swarming around you want to do, you have my love and my blessing. I'm sorry this only came clear to me now that I'm dying, but tripping Queens? What a fool not telling my father to fuck off, like the old man would ever love me. Pushing your mother away. What a ballless coward I am. And then there's your brother. Why? But why? I mean, what kind of god? What kind of world? It's a stinking con game. You grow up being told, wait for the sweets and the roses. Then they hit you with a pickaxe in the ear. Grief, they say you pass through it. Bullshit! They say, don't get angry. Oh, let it go, it's killing you. I say, fuck that! Anger's the only thing they left me. Anger's my refuge, it's my shield. Anger is my birthright! What you dreamed? I didn't want to hear it. I was wrong. I hope you can forgive me. I pray for your happiness. Whatever swarming around you want to do, you have my love and my blessing. I'm sorry this only came clear to me now that I'm dying, but it's how life rolls out. The only people who don't look back with regret are idiots and psychopaths. And I got a lifetime of regrets, boy. Taken to a clerkship in Queens? What a fool not telling my father to fuck off, like the old man would ever love me. Pushing your mother away. What a ballless coward I am. And then there's your brother. Why? But why? I mean, what kind of god? What kind of world? It's a stinking con game. You grew up being told, wait for the sweets and the roses. Then they hit you with a pickaxe in the ear.
grief. They say you pass through it. Bullshit!
And they say, don't get angry. Oh, let it go. It's killing you. I say, fuck that! Anger's the only thing they left me. Anger's my refuge. It's my shield. Anger is my dark night!
Well, don't look back with regret. We're idiots and psychopaths. And I got a lifetime of regrets, boy. Taking that clerkship in Queens? What a fool not telling my father to fuck off. Like the old man would ever love me. Pushing your mother away. What a ballless coward I am. And then there's your brother. Why? Oh, why? I mean, what kind of god? What kind of world? It's a stinking con game. You grew up being told, wait for the sweets and the roses. Then they hit you with a pickaxe in the ear. Grief, they say you pass through it. Bullshit! And they say, don't get angry. Oh, let it go, it's killing you. I say, fuck that! Anger's the only thing they left me. Anger's my refuge, it's my shield. Anger is my birthright! I hope you can forgive me.
Well, I turn it off.
It's the fucking record button.
Check. And action.
Tommy, I'll make this as simple as I can. I love you. That's my rock bottom. That's my immutable. My damned and naked soul. I loved you from the moment you were born, all red and covered in mucusy stuff, until this moment right now. They say that love is pure and generous. It's not small and selfish. You know, I wanted you at the office because I couldn't envision anything finer than having you next to me. Altman. What a dream. What you wanted, what you dreamed, I didn't want to hear it. I was wrong. I hope you can forgive me. I pray for your happiness. Whatever swanning around you want to do, you have my love and my blessing. I'm sorry this only came clear to me now that I'm dying, but it's how life rolls out. The only people who don't look back with regret are idiots and psychopaths. And I got a lifetime of regrets, boy. Taking that clerkship in Queens? What a fool not telling my father to fuck off. Like the old man would ever love me. Pushing your mother away. What a ballless coward I am. And then there's your brother. Why? Oh, why? I mean, what kind of god? What kind of world? It's a stinking con game. You grew up being told, wait for the sweets and the roses. Then they hit you with a pickaxe in the ear. Grief, they say you pass through it. Bullshit! They say, don't get angry. Oh, let it go, it's killing you. I say, fuck that! Anger's the only thing they left me. Anger's my refuge, it's my shit. I am. And then there's your brother. Why? Oh, why? I mean, what kind of god? What kind of world? It's a stinking con game. You grew up being told, wait for the sweets and the roses. Then they hit you with a pickaxe in the ear. Grief, they say you pass through it. Bullshit! And they say, don't get angry. Oh, let it go, it's killing you. I say, fuck that! Anger's the only thing they left me. Anger's my refuge, it's my shield. Anger is my birthright!
Thank you. Olive Garden. Do not do this to me, Olive Garden. I've drank over a fucking gallon of fucking hard alcohol in the last day. I'm sorry to interrupt. What was that, Richard? 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 What are you doing, mate?
Let me get back on you. Don't get bloody
effort, what? You're
getting bloody what now? What? Got your mind.
How are them cockatoos cheating you? They're not beating you up, are they? I said, are the cockatoos beating you up? Tell me if they are, I'll call the police.
Hey, Will.
Yes.
Is that Captain Obvious in trouble?
Yes.
Oh, that's alright. I just wanted to know. I bet you feel better now, do you?
No, I'm nearly out of vodka. How the fuck you think I feel? I feel like I want some more fucking vodka is what I feel like.
I thought you got some smokes, sir.
I shouldn't have gave that fucking money to Joe. I just could have went out and got more vodka. It's alright. It's alright. I need to sober up sooner or later.
You got some
green fights? I've got a few smokes. Joe gave me some pot. There might be a hit in that bong. If I'm lucky.
What about your neighbors? Did you come home yet?
Yeah, I just told you. I went to the neighbors. Talked to Joe. He gave me some weed. I paid him money for the money he gave me yesterday.
Oh, yeah, that's good.
You know what's not? I should have kept the money and went and got more vodka. That was a long time ago. Now I've got this much left. I'm getting desperate.
You know, I can hear you better, but I'm not watching you, and I'm looking at a blue screen, but when I'm watching you, I can't really grasp what you're saying. You know, I have to sort of watch the blue screen. Does that make any sense?
Yes, it's Australian TV.
Yeah, I have to watch a blue screen to hear what you're saying. Otherwise, I just get echoes all the time.
Perhaps you have not quite figured out the buttons on your controller.
Yeah, I've done all that. Nah, it's okay. I can hear you really cool, mate. You're
doing
all right,
William. I'm low on booze, and it's really making me depressed. Yes, being low on vodka is making me depressed.
Shit.
It's all right. I'll get past it.
What about your mum? Can't you meet her up?
No. I don't even know where the fuck my phone is.
Oh, yeah. Well, your mama dropped your bottle of vodka off.
I'd ring up Shauna if I knew where my fucking phone is.
Yeah, well, you want me to give you a ring?
You don't know my phone number. I don't even know my phone number.
It's alright.
Give you my mom's phone number, yeah. Didn't I already do that? Can't give me a ring? I don't know my number!
I know! It's up to you, mate. It's up to you, mate. No problem.
Well, I'm comfortable on here. At least here there's no long-distance phone charge.
Yeah, I know. That's understandable. I know. You're right. I don't want you to do anything you don't want to do, you know. So what are you gonna do, mate?
I'm gonna play another fucking song. I can't hear you anymore, mate. I've gone to the other realm, the music realm. Karen O was very good. I liked the Viking song. Ah, oh, I should've just...
I just like all of you. I like music. Fantastic.
I think I'm gonna play some Tom Petty. Yes, Tom Petty sounds good. Shit, I dropped my cigarette. Tom yeah. Petty.
I'm buying it now. Tom Petty.
Stand by me. Aren't you? Stand by me. Won't you? Stand by me.
Anytime you want me to find it, I'm happy to do that, William.
Won't back down. Stand me up at the gates of hell and I won't back down.
I'm happy to leave you, buddy. Anytime. I mean, I wish I could do something for you, but I'm not there. I'm not here.
Thank you.
Circus Factory.
Bedford Harbor in rural England, July 1944. Returning from the Normandy beachhead. Many of them on stretchers. Some are shipmates of the Coast Guardsmen in this barracks. It's hard to forget that. It's even harder to forget the others who will never come back to us. It seems almost like yesterday. If only you could have seen this harbor then, the ugly, flat-bottomed LCIs. The smaller craft always on the go. The snub-nosed LCVPs that would spearhead the coming invasion. The fast Coast Guard rescue cutters that later were to save so many lives. Hundreds of ships and landing craft, each with its specific job. You remember young Bill Jackson, who sang in your boys' choir? He was serving aboard the rescue cutter Flying Angel. For months, Bill and the others were put through invasion maneuvers. They called them dry runs, and other terms not in our vocabulary. By now, the GIs were resigned to these seagoing excursions, and convinced they had joined the Marines. Our men began to feel they were running a water taxi service. They kept hoping each dry run might turn out to be more than just another rehearsal. Whenever the flotilla lost sight of land, you could feel the growing tension aboard ship. But always the objective turned out to be another section of the English coast. Our boys would go through the same never-changing procedure. Get the infantry aboard the landing craft, and then head in fast for the beaches. Soldiers and sailors all thought they were pretty good by now. They were, except for a few minor kinks. And so it went. Until they'd established another beachhead in England. But it was the aftermath of every maneuver that really got our Coast Guardsmen down. Maintenance to them was just more monotonous routine. Get everything shipshape, so it could be all fouled up in the next dry run. Sometimes, if the lads were lucky, liberty ashore met a date. They were lonely for the long-remembered friendships of home. It helped, even for a little while, to get away from the ships, and the maneuvers, and the war they felt they weren't fighting.
Barricade and drop their ranks.
there, the troops waded through deep water to the shore. Many never reached it. Came shouldering in with more infantry to reinforce our hard-won foothold. And equipment were shuttled in from the sea. We landed more medical field units. The severely wounded were carried to the relative safety of outlying hospital ships and transports. Seas. But now the full fury of a channel gale swept our invasion coast. taken its toll, adding to the high price we had already paid in men and ships.
Little does anyone ever know that Canadians were the first ones to step foot on the battlefield during World War I and World War II.
Much greater force.
And this is why I'm not buying Star Wars.
For every family that lives Star Wars.
Suck a dick.
That's where Star Wars lives. For a galaxy far, far away.
No! No! Fuck you! Fuck your Star Wars! The new movie sucked ass!
15 places to visit before you die, or 10 awesome places to release your inner adventurer, we present to you 15 places you aren't allowed to visit. They are ultra secretive, or downright scary. So take a good look now, because the chance to visit some of them is zero. Number 15, Club 33. Disneyland is a place where every kid dreams of going someday. If you are a parent on the other side, that means long lines for the rides, overpriced souvenirs, and thousands of screaming children. Most of the visitors there probably never heard of Club 33, the only magical place grown-ups need. You wonder what's so special about it? Well, Club 33 is the only place in Disneyland that sells alcohol. What's more magic than that? The place where Walt Disney hosted imported people is available if you manage to get on the 14-year waiting list and pay $40,000 for membership. 14, the Queen's bedroom. The Queen's official residence has 240 bedrooms. However, the most important of them all, the Queen's bedroom, was part of the so-called Michael Fagan incident. In 1982, this man entered the Queen's bedroom and sat on the edge of her bed while she was asleep and woke her up so he could talk with her about his problem. Later, Her Majesty left the room to call security, and Michael asked for some cigarettes from the staff to compliment the whiskey he had stolen earlier from the palace. What nerve. Turns out that he was high on magic mushroom. Thanks to Mr. Fagan, now we know that the security sucks big time. 13. Air Force One. A wise man once said, it's not about the destination, it's about the journey. Inspired by this quote, we decided to include the official plane of the President of the United States of America. The flying White House is definitely the best way to travel in style. Designed to withstand air attacks with communication systems that can't be stopped even with a nuclear blast, Air Force One has unlimited range and doesn't need to stop to refuel. Every detail about the plane is top secret, and not even important politicians are allowed to take a sneak peek. 12. Surtsey. Surtsey is a volcanic island formed in 1967 and located near Iceland. The only people allowed there are scientists, who made sure there was a natural ecological succession without human influence. 11. North Sentinel Island. There are so many beautiful tropical islands worth visiting, but this is not one of them. You ask why? Well, trying to visit the North Sentinel Island in the Bay of Bengal can literally cost you your life. The indigenous people who live there have a very strict no-visitors-allowed policy, and I can't blame them. Who wants to share this beauty with noisy tourists taking obnoxious selfies by the beach? 10. Woomera Prohibited Area. If you are visiting Australia, it's good to know that there is only one place you are not allowed to enter. Woomera is a weapons testing range operated by the Australian Air Force. It is also a place for rocket launches, atomic bomb trials, and experimental programs. If you are still not convinced, let me tell you that the area is practically a minefield, a place where you have a 95% chance of getting your legs blown off. 9. Lasso Caves.
Rooma, Australia, a 95% chance of getting your fucking legs blown off by a minefield. 95% chance? That's more than fucking Iraq. Richard, explain this to me. Hold on, don't explain it to me now. I've still got some booze left to drink. In Australia, in Rumour,
They have over like a million mines. The only reason you're not allowed to go there is because you're going to blow off one of your legs. Oh, kitty cat. Oh, that's a mean kitty. Meow!
Hi, kitty.
On the scale.
Nice. burgers and fries.
Thank you. The fuck? Really? All right.
Okay.
You more idea.
You need an idea. What does that mean in Russian? You need run ye. You need run ye. Give me money. No, but really. You need money. Cats are fucking cool. I mean, come on. They do stupid shit. We find it fucking adorable. I'm getting close to my last song, so please enjoy what's left. On the stove, you know. You hungry? I can make you food. I'm hungry. Soon, you can eat soon. Just give it like 20, 30 more minutes and I'm done.
sorry, I just came out with my new lyrics to that fucking song. Hope you got message something to me there. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Richard. I love you. As your friend and a brother from another mother. Even so, you do not think like I do. Wir müssen da Juden ausstrotten. Wir müssen da Juden ausstrotten. Sich heil, sich heil. Haben Sie ein Streichholz für meine Zigaretten? Soup? Is it soup?
No, not yet.
Pretty close. I am so ready to strip down into my underwear. My ass is sore. I've been sitting in a fucking steel chair all day. Of course my ass is sore. I'm gonna eat some food and fucking pretend I'm not here stuck at home. There's a few more drinks left. There's a few more drinks left. Can I just lay down? I just want to lay down. I know. I'm hungry. I don't want to keep going. I think I'm done.
We won here, and here, and here, here, and here, here. Also in here, back there, behind here, even next to these guys here. In the nation's largest independent study, Root Metrics just named Verizon number one network for the fifth time in a row, here. So when the other guys claim they're the best, remember, there's only one number one. And now we'll pay up to $650 to switch to the best network. This one, right here.
Judging by the Americans that we're stuck with today,
Would it be so bad to take their guns away? I mean, really. The new generation is gonna be left with a shitload of guns. We only kept that law legal so we'd never be invaded, but now we're being... They deserve it. They deserve it. They thought they'd win the war by defeating the Confederacy, but no. No, you lost. Thought it was smart to put black kids in the same school as white kids, didn't you? You fucked up, didn't you? You made a mistake, and you refuse to own up to it. Because you're not a racist. But seriously, Auschwitz says burn in hell.
This past year. And to celebrate, we're extending our 50% offer so you can save on most Verizon, AT&T, or T-Mobile rates. Now save $200 instantly when you get the Samsung Galaxy Note 5 or GS6 and trade in your smartphone. So switch today.
Uncle Pudge told me how Granny used to fuck Tom, and okay, my cousin was able to respond faster than I was. His first response was, "Why? Why?" Why did you put that image in my head, you dick? Oh yeah, I want to think about Granny. Picture Granny having sex. God damn, she's 82 now. Jesus fucking Christ. That was Tom. Tom died when I was about 4. James put me up on his shoulders and, first time I saw a corpse, I was 4 years old. 4 years old, I see my first dead body. He was sprawled out over, leaning for the telephone like he was going to call 911 or something. Guess he never made it. Poor guy. He was a very, very good person. One of those people that you would want to live.